Hi, and welcome back to the Grafana Alloy for Beginners series. I'm Lisa Jung, a staff developer advocate at Grafana. In the last few episodes, we built pipelines to collect infrastructure logs and metrics. As we add more pipelines, our configuration grows more complex and debugging gets trickier. That's where the Alloy UI comes in. It helps us visualize what's happening in our pipelines so we can quickly spot issues and debug more efficiently. In this episode, we'll use the Alloy UI to explore and understand the pipelines we've built so far. Before getting started, make sure your learning environment is up and running. Go to your browser and open the Alloy UI at localhost 12347. We'll see a list of all the components that we've defined in our config.alloy, along with their health status. When we click on the View button, it'll take us to the Component Detail page. This page shows the health of the component, the arguments it's using, as well as its exports. Now, when you scroll up, you'll see that this component is called prometheus.relabel.postgres, which is the component we defined in the previous episode. So let's take a look at its arguments. Now, you'll see the three rule blocks that we defined in the last episode for the labels group, service, and instance. And when you scroll up, you can also access the component's documentation by clicking on this button here, as well as a live debugging view. Now, when you click on that, we see a real-time stream of telemetry flowing through a component. From here, we can pause and clear the data stream, sample data and disable auto-scrolling to handle heavy loads, search through the data using keywords, and copy the entire data stream to the clipboard. It's a great way to inspect what's happening under the hood. Next up is a graph page, which is a really helpful tool. Click on graph at the top to open it. This page gives us a visual map of all of our components and how they're connected. Right now, we see the three pipelines we built so far for collecting, processing, and exporting infrastructure logs and metrics. So let's zoom in on the logs pipeline. The dotted lines between components are color-coded by data type, and we can match them using the legend at the top. The number on each line shows the data transfer rate. That rate is calculated based on the window setting above. For example, a window of 10 means Alloy calculates a per second rate over the last 10 seconds. Now, you can even drag components around to rearrange them, so it's super easy to organize and understand your pipeline. Next, we have the clustering page. We can access this page by clicking on the option up top. A cluster node is an instance of Alloy that participates in workload distribution and ensures high availability. This page shows the status and role of each node, so we can easily see which nodes are active, their addresses, and its current state. To debug using the Alloy UI, make sure all components are showing as healthy. Check that the arguments and exports for any misbehaving components are correctly configured. Use live debugging to confirm that the data flowing through each component matches your expectations. In this episode, we use the Alloy UI to explore and better understand the state of the pipelines we've built so far. Up next, Mischa will show you how to take things further by building pipelines for application metrics, traces, and logs using Alloy. Stay tuned!